In this screencast, we're going to look at an example of a combustion reaction. Here we have the combustion of methane, which is CH4. Methane is the main component in natural gas, and anytime we're talking about the combustion of hydrocarbons, there's two competing reactions that can occur. The first reaction shows the example of complete combustion of methane. In complete combustion, all carbons converted to carbon dioxide. The second reaction shows partial combustion, and in partial combustion, all carbon contents converted to carbon monoxide. In this example, we're given a couple pieces of information. We're going to assume a basis of 100 moles of methane that are fed to the reactor, and we know that air is fed at 25% excess. Inside the reactor, we have complete conversion of methane and no partial combustion. Based on this information, we want to find the moles of air that are fed to the reactor and the moles of each component in the stat gas. To accomplish this, we're going to have to set up a system of molecular species balance on each species in the process. Before we start setting up and solving the system of equations, it's important to have a fully labeled process diagram. Based on the information that's been specified, take the time to set up a fully labeled process flowchart. An example of a labeled diagram is shown at the bottom. The first two pieces of information that are given are telling us something about the feed to the reactor. Here we have our basis of 100 moles of methane, and we have an unknown variable N air to represent the feed to the reactor. We don't know how much air there is, but we know it's at 25% excess, and we also know the composition. We know that air is 21% oxygen and 79% nitrogen by mole. The last two pieces of information that are given are telling us something about what's happening inside the reactor and influences what we would expect to see in the stat gas. For example, we know that there's complete conversion of methane, so we know we won't find any methane in the output. We also know there's no partial combustion, so we also wouldn't expect to see any carbon monoxide in the output. So this is implying that all methane is combusted via complete combustion, and the reaction is shown below. The complete combustion reaction shows us that we should expect to find carbon dioxide in the output, as well as the other product, which is water. And because air is fed at excess, we know that all the oxygen is not going to be consumed in the reaction. Air is primarily nitrogen, which is inert in this case, so we're also going to have nitrogen in the output as well. So with all the relevant species accounted for, we should be able to start setting up our system of equations. We'll start by using the definition of the percent excess of air to find out how much air is being fed to the reactor. The definition of percent excess of air is the moles of air that are fed to the reactor minus the moles of air that are theoretically required to consume all of the fuel divided by the theoretical moles of air. The moles of air that are fed is what we're trying to find out. The moles of air that are theoretically required are based on our 100 moles of methane that are fed, as well as the reaction stoichiometry. Here we can see that for every mole of methane that's consumed, we need 2 moles of oxygen. We can find the amount of oxygen we need by taking our 100 moles of methane and multiplying it by the molar ratio that oxygen is consumed for every mole of methane. That gives us 200 moles of oxygen that we need to completely consume all the methane. However, we're not feeding pure oxygen to the reactor, so we need to find the theoretical amount of air that's required to supply 200 moles of oxygen. If we take into account that every mole of air has 0.21 moles of oxygen, we can multiply by that ratio to get the 952 moles of air that we theoretically need in this case. With the amount of air that we theoretically need accounted for, we can use the equation for the percent excess to find how much air is actually being fed. We know that air is being supplied at 25% excess. We're trying to find out the moles of air that are being fed, and we just calculated that we theoretically need 952 moles. So if we plug into the equation, we should find that the moles of air that we're feeding to the reactor is equal to 1190 moles in this case. Now that we know how much air we're feeding to the reactor, we should be able to set up a system of molecular species balance to find all of the amounts of each component in the stat gas. If we're writing a molecular species balance on a particular component, we're relating the moles out to the moles in through the extent of reaction. The moles out is equal to the moles in plus the stoichiometric coefficient for that species I times the extent of reaction. And we can write that for every reactant and product in the reaction. For example, if we apply that to methane, we know that there's no moles of methane that are leaving the reactor. We have 100 moles that are going in. The stoichiometric coefficient is -1 because it's a reactant, times the extent of reaction. From this equation, we can see that the extent of reaction is equal to 100 moles. If we apply this to the product, carbon dioxide, The amount of carbon dioxide leaving is represented by the variable N1. We have no carbon dioxide entering the reactor. The stoichiometric coefficient is positive 1 because it's a product, and we're multiplying that by the extent of reaction. And we can apply that to water and oxygen as well. The amount of water leaving is given the variable N2. We have no water going in. We're generating 2 moles of water for every mole of methane that reacts times the extent of reaction. For oxygen, the variable is N3. The input of oxygen is 0.21 times the total moles of air, which we calculated as 1190. This is also a reactant, so we have a negative 2 for the stoichiometric coefficient times the extent of reaction. If we insert 100 moles for the extent of reaction into these balances, we can find the flow rates for carbon dioxide, water, and oxygen. The last thing we need to find is the moles of nitrogen that are leaving. We don't need to write a molecular species balance in terms of the extent of reaction because in this case, nitrogen doesn't react. It's inert, which means that whatever goes in is coming right back out. So we can write a balance of the form N equals out. In this case, what's going in is 0.79 times the total moles of air that we found. Again, that's 1190, and that must be equal to N4. And if we make that calculation, we'll find that N4 is equal to 940 moles of nitrogen. So in the example of the complete combustion of methane, we've shown that we can relate the amount of air that's being fed to the reactor for a given amount of fuel, given the percent excess. And we can relate the reactor output to what's being fed through stoichiometry, the extent of reaction, and molecular species balances.